Welcome to the Fantasy Pros YouTube channel. My name is Andrew Erickson, also known as Big Pod Energy. And today I'm coming at you with my top 10 league winners for 2022. Let's go. Number 10, running back Melvin Gordon, Denver Broncos. Gordon is bound to be written off by fantasy draft pundits this offseason due to his age, but he proved that he still has gas in the tank in 2021. The 29-year-old running back was efficient across the board, ranking 8th in both PFF rushing grade and forced missed tackles while compiling 231 touches, which ranked 16th in the NFL. Gordon finished right behind Javonte Williams as the fantasy RB18 and played one fewer game. With MG3 back on a high-powered offense and with the potential to receive goal line touches as he did so last season, Gordon could easily become a league-winning running back that you can draft late in 2022 like James Conner or Leonard Fournette last year. Number 9, wide receiver Marquise Brown, Arizona Cardinals. Brown seems slated for a massive target share in the Cardinals' pass-heavy offense, especially with DeAndre Hopkins sidelined for the first big 6 weeks of the season. Brown has already shown the ability to command targets at a high rate after posting a top 12 23% target share last year with Baltimore. The speedy wideout also commanded a whopping 27% target share back in 2018 at Oklahoma, the last time he played with quarterback Kyler Murray. He's the perfect fit with his old college QB, who finished last season as PFF's highest graded passer on 20-plus air yard throws. Brown desperately needed a more accurate downfield passer after catching just 5 of 30 deep balls last season. Number 8, running back Travis Etienne, Jacksonville Jaguars. With James Robinson attempting to come back from a torn Achilles injury suffered on December 26th, Travis Etienne figures to be the featured back after a lost rookie season. During his final year as a Clemson Tiger, he led the country in receiving yards and ranked 2nd in receptions among all running backs. Etienne also racked up the most rushing attempts of 20-plus yards from 2018 to 2019, while only carrying the ball 20-plus times once since 2018. With an explosive pass-catching skill set, Etienne checks off all the requisite boxes of a fantasy running back poised to make noise in 2022, and he can be obtained for the suppressed price of a back-end fantasy RB2. Number 7, running back Cam Akers, Los Angeles Rams. There's simply too much emphasis placed on Cam Akers' poor production at the tail end of 2021, 2.4 yards per carry, amid a juggernaut of tough run defenses that no Rams running back could run efficiently against. 95% of his rushing yards in 2021 came after contact, the highest mark in the NFL. Touch volume is the key driver of fan success at the running back position. In the Rams' divisional playoff win versus the Bucks, Akers played 81% of the snaps and outtouched Sony Michel 27-3. I expect Akers to be dialed back in as the top running back next season in Sean McVay's consistent one running back offense, where the team's lead back averages 20-plus touches per game. Darrell Henderson has proved he's nothing more than a replaceable running back. Not to mention, Akers has a cakewalk of soft run defenses to open the season. Bills, Falcons, and Cardinals. Won't take long for Akers to pay off his early round 4 ADP in a high-powered offense. Number 6, running back Saquon Barkley. Once a locked and loaded top 5 fantasy football selection, Barkley is now routinely selected in the third round. His inability to stay healthy has hindered him from being able to recapture his rookie form in addition to the Giants' horrible situation on offense, but under a new coaching staff and vastly improved offensive line, there's reason to buy back on Barkley at a massive discount. In 5 games last season when Barkley played a full snap share with Daniel Jones under center, the Giants running back averaged 16.2 PPR points per game, good for the RB10. And before his freak injury versus the Cowboys, he averaged 23 fantasy points per game in his 2 healthy starts. He's still a running back at just 25 years old that looks slated to recapture his rookie form when he caught 91 passes. Number 5, Jalen Hurts, quarterback for the Philadelphia Eagles. Hurts has been a top 12 fantasy quarterback at an 85% clip in the 20 games he's played all 4 quarters in throughout his NFL career. And there's no reason to think that Hurts won't continue producing in fantasy with the addition of A.J. Brown and if the Eagles decide to throw more in 2022. They threw at the 2nd highest rate on early downs under a neutral game script to open the first 6 weeks of last season. The sky's the limit for the Eagles passing game in 2022. Fly, Eagles, fly. Number 4, wide receiver Mike Williams, Los Angeles Chargers. Big Mike finished the season as the wide receiver 23 in fantasy points per game, coming off career highs in targets, catches, and yards per route run, despite cooling off considerably in the later weeks, in addition to leaving a boatload of touchdown production on the table. He finished 6th in end zone targets, 16, but caught only 5 for touchdowns. With positive touchdown regression set on the horizon and a resume that features a double-digit touchdown season, Williams appears primed to score 10-plus touchdowns in 2022 and repeat his wide receiver 12 finish in half-point scoring attached to up-and-coming elite quarterback Justin Herbert. Number 3, wide receiver Michael Pittman Jr., Indianapolis Colts. Michael Pittman is entering year 3 and should be viewed as a legitimate alpha wide receiver based on his accomplishments from 2021. Third in route participation behind Cooper Kupp and Ja'Marr Chase. Eighth in target share, was 31% from weeks 13 through 18. And the only reason he didn't finish higher than wide receiver 15 in half-point scoring was that the Colts' offense ranked 29th in pass play rate and 27th in overall pass attempts. With a more trustworthy quarterback who has a track record of fueling fantasy wide receiver ones and hyper-targeting alphas in Matt Ryan under center for the 2022 season, Pittman has the legitimate chance to make the leap into the top 12 wide receiver one conversation and alter the tides of fantasy football leagues. Number 2, wide receiver Gabriel Davis for the Buffalo Bills. The Bills eventually saw the error of their ways of playing a dusty Emmanuel Sanders and unleashed Gabriel Davis from week 14 onward. The second-year wide receiver averaged 19.8 fantasy points per game in PPR and 16 expected fantasy points per game in his last 6 games as a full-time player. As a strong bet to earn the number 2 wide receiver job coming day 1, Davis has a legitimate shot to be a league winner in a Josh Allen-led offense in 2022. Despite being a part-time player only the last 2 seasons, the former UCF Knight ranks top 5 in the NFL in total end zone targets. Davis is also just one of 2 wide receivers to rank top 5 in yards per catch over the last 2 seasons. And without further ado, number 1 overall, wide receiver Courtland Sutton, Denver Broncos. Sutton has a real chance to recapture his elite 2019 form, another year removed from his ACL injury, with Russell Wilson as his new quarterback. Wilson has always been an elite downfield passer. He had the 6th highest passer rating on throws of 20-plus air yards last season, which plays heavily into Sutton's strengths as a vertical threat. Based on the receiver's track record of commanding targets near the pylon, I fully expect Sutton to emerge as Wilson's go-to red zone target. He led the Broncos in red zone targets in 2021, led all wide receivers in target rate inside the 10-yard line in 2019. Wilson has an affinity for attacking receivers in the red zone. A Seattle wide receiver has finished top 5 in red zone targets for 3 straight seasons. Simply put, the fit between Wilson and Sutton could not be better for 2022, and I'm not afraid to go all in and declare that Sutton will be this year's Cooper Kupp. And there you have it, folks. Andrew Erickson's top 10 league winners for fantasy football. Draft these guys, and good things will happen. And as always, if you liked the video, please give it a like, subscribe, and share with your friends, just not the ones in your fantasy league.
Thanks for tuning in to the Fantasy Pros YouTube channel. Don't forget to check out our featured videos. And while you're at it, make sure to follow us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter at Fantasy Pros, so you can get the latest news and updates to give you the edge you need in your fantasy league.